All right, starting off first with a 1969 D mint mark. By the way, the D mint mark will be right above the date there on these Roosevelt dimes. Now, this coin does not have any type of mint errors. However, it is valuable. This dime sold for over $600 because it is graded at a mint state 67 with full bands. So here's an example of what full bands looks like on the Roosevelt dime. Full bands is a designation that the coin grading company will give your dimes when grading them. That's the same for Mercury dimes as well. They can't be worn down or anything. This coin is in excellent condition and it has those full bands. Mint state 67 is a very high grade. The coin grading scale only goes up to 70. 70 is the best condition you can get. That's why the coin sold for $630. Now here is a 1969 that has a mint error. So you'll want to look at your 1969 D mint marks up close. You want to use your coin microscopes for that. I have those available on couchcollectibles.com. Link is below every single video I upload. But let's look at the RPM. So here's a good example of what you want to look for. A 1969 D with a repunched mint mark, RPM. So the D mint mark here has been repunched. If you look northeast, up there to the right of the D mint mark, you'll see the outline of another D mint mark. So that mint mark has been repunched. So this coin does have a very high grade as well. It's graded at a mint state 66. So that will give it some value as well. And that's why this coin sold for over $100. Now you're not gonna make a fortune on a coin like this. You know, if it's in really terrible condition with this repunched mint mark, probably not going to sell for much, but definitely worth keeping, but maybe not worth grading if it's not in very good condition. All right, so here's another mint error. This is the 1969 D mint mark Roosevelt dime that has been double struck, and that second strike is 90% off center, which we can clearly see here in the images displayed. Graded by Annex at an AU53. And this coin sold for a little over $100 as well. Actually, that coin sold with this coin. So both of these coins sold together for $109. So not bad, around 50 bucks a coin. Can't beat that. This is a no-dated coin that has been struck off-center. It also does have a straight clip as well. So not too bad for both of those coins, 50 bucks a piece basically. Let's move on here to a 1969 no mint mark. So Philadelphia minted Roosevelt dime here, graded by PCGS at a mint state 67. So that's where all the value comes in at, is the high grade. Same thing we looked at the first coin, the 1969 D mint mark high grade. This is the no mint mark high grade. And this dime sold for over $470. Now here is a missing clad layer. So here on the reverse of this dime, looks very normal. But here on the obverse, you'll see the inner copper layer because the outer clad layer is missing on the obverse, the front of the coin here. And this coin is graded at a mint state 62 by NGC. This dime ended up selling for around $50. Now this next coin is kind of the opposite. So it's 1969 D, but it's missing the reverse clad layer. So the front looks normal, but the reverse is missing the clad layer. This coin sold for around $85. So not too bad. Always check both sides of your coins. Of course, you can look for that on quarters and other coins as well. Now here is a 1969 S proof Roosevelt dime that has a very high grade of a proof 69 deep cameo. Now 70 is a perfect grade. You cannot get any higher than a 70. This is at a 69. This dime ended up selling for around $200 because of that high grade. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.